In this video, I want to talk about some basic measurement techniques with the Faro arm and the CAM2 software. So we have our Faro arm, it's turned on and ready to go. The Faro arm has a little hook right here for the probe. If you bring it right off of the hook, right, it comes right toward you. If somebody leaves it off the hook like so, sometimes you'll go to pull it toward you and it won't go anywhere. Look for these hooks, spin them toward you, Faro arm comes right down. As far as using this, pretty user friendly. The only thing I'd probably say is you don't have to hold the arm right here. You can just let it drop. You really only need to manipulate this part. As far as the controls, green button, red button. Green button takes points, red button tells it to stop taking points. Now, as far as our program goes, I'll pull it up on the screen here. Here's our CAM2 software. We'll start in the home tab. We'll import our CAD model. I've had the best luck with step models, but it says it can accept any of these on this list. It's going to use the origin from the CAD model. So the way I modeled this part, the origin is in this bottom corner where all three surface datum planes intersect. Now we need to tell the machine and the software where the part is in real life. So we're going to do an alignment. So I'll go right here. There's multiple ways to do alignments. I'm just going to show you one. I like the feature based. You don't have to for a CMM alignment, but if it's convenient, I recommend just picking the datum features. I'm going to hit next, and it's going to ask us to measure those datum features, which I'm going to do here. So I'm going to take some points. Every time I hit the green button, it will take a point. I simply place the probe on the part surface, press the green button. And we're going to press the red button away from the surface, right? Not toward the inside of the part, toward the outside of the part. That makes sense, right? Now it's automatically going to go to plane 2. I'll start taking points on this bottom surface and hit the red button away from the part. And when I say inside the part, outside the part, obviously you can't go inside the solid material of the part, but hit the red button here as opposed to here in this direction. Hope that makes sense. Now plane 3, couple points, red button. The way the alignment works, right, these are real planes in real life, so they're not going to be perfectly oriented to each other. So there's always going to be a little bit of error there. I'm just going to hit finish. Now a little bit of housekeeping. I just just like you would in any Windows program, select this, or you can go here to rename. Just rename these A, B, and C. Now, I just want to get a couple of measurements. So we'll get this measurement, and then we'll get the height of the block. So the way I'm going to do that, I'm going to go to pick from CAD, pick features. I'm going to select this plane and this plane. Now I'm going to rename these opposite A, and then opposite B, okay? Why don't we go ahead and select this cylinder while we're at it. Right. I'm gonna go to the home tab. I'm going to select all of these three with the shift key. And there's a couple ways to do it. I could go up here to the measure all, and it'll ask me if I wanna remeasure previously measured features, in which I'd hit no, or I can right click here and then go to add readings, right? Either one works fine. So we're gonna do opposite A. This is a good time to show this, And we don't have to just hit the green button to take a point. If I go to mode, I can go to time or distance interval. I prefer distance. And we can set a distance in which it'll take a point as you're moving it. So it's set to 10 thousandths now. So let's give that a try. Instead of pressing, I'm going to hold the green button down and move it across the part. So this is kind of like scanning with the Zeiss CMM. The advantage here is that, well, it could be a disadvantage, but so 1500 point, close to 1500 points taken, red button. The advantage, disadvantage, whatever you want to call it, is you're in control. So it's almost like a height gauge or an indicator where if you see something suspicious, you can check it out pretty easily. On a gantry CMM, of course, you can change the program, but you would have to go in and change your strategy to go look at an area, maybe if two parts are, you know, that you checked are different. Whereas here, you know, the downside is it's always manual, right? There is no, you know, gantry to move it around for you. So there can be operator, you know, error, probably more with this, but for certain situations, it could be pretty handy. Now opposite B, this is top surface. Red button. And then we'll do our cylinder. And the cylinder, I'm going to switch back to single point. If you make, let me grab a couple. All right, so on the screen we can see your cylindricity. If you make a mistake, say you hit the green button way outside of the, you know, feature, you'll see the form go way up, right? That's bad. Just hit backspace on your keyboard and it'll delete the previous point. It doesn't work as well when you're scanning, like taking a lot of points, and you have to hit backspace a lot. So I'll do the best I can to get some points here. Then we hit the red button inside of the part. So now we've got a cylinder and some opposing planes. Let's chat real quick about how we get measurements. For the distance between the two planes, we'll go in the Home tab, Length from Features, and we're gonna select A and opposite A, Create. It's automatically going to go to length 2, so we're going to select B, and opposite B. If you notice the colors here, the red has been measured, the kind of purple is just a CAD thing. All right, create, and then close. The diameter is going to get automatically reported when we pull up our report, which I'll show you right here. Down here, the report tab, click on that. Takes a second, at least on my computer, to load up. We want to go to add to report, select our lengths and our cylinder, add. Scroll down here. It will give us, for whatever reason, to add it in opposite B. It's fine. The length here, right, and we've got to pay attention to the direction X, Y, and Z. And then our cylinder, it gives us a diameter, and then cylindricity. CAM2 does that for some reason. It automatically assigns a form tolerance to basically every feature. This is an odd workflow to me, right? When you're actually measuring stuff, it doesn't like show you. I mean, you can kind of get to it, but to really get this information, you have to go to the report. Maybe there's a better way to do it. If there is, let me know in the comments. It's a kind of odd workflow, but it all works okay. Fairly simple to use. I think this is one of the toughest things for me to get used to, is switching from the features to the report. So if I want to go back to the features, create another length, you know, add in GD&T, that kind of thing, this is how I would do it. In another video, I'll talk about the GD&T tab. Pretty straightforward, right? I would say it's somewhat limited in GD&T, but what it has seems to work pretty well. So I'll save that for a further video. If you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe. Leave a comment down below.